Hello there, Kyle Katarn here, and it is Wednesday, my dudes. You know what that means. It's time to read some comics. We've got two official releases today. I thought there was going to be three. Turns out I had a scheduling mix-up. But we're going to do Shadow of Vader's Castle by Kevon Scott and Derek Charm. That's right, Kevon Scott is involved, which means Jackson's probably not far behind. And then we're going to do Star Wars number 8 by Charles Soule and Ramon Rosanas. See the showdown between Leia and Zara finally conclude. I hope they don't kill Zara because she's a cool character, and I'd like them to introduce an Imperial that actually sticks around for a while. But first, Shadow of Vader's Castle. By Kevon Scott and Derek Charm. Look at this. This is some epic cover art. I'm digging it a lot. You know, the whole concept of Fortress Vader, I just really like the idea behind it. Back in Darth Vader, Dark Lords of the Sith, issue number 21, we learned that Vader actually built it on a pre-existing, like a Sith cave that was strong in the dark side. It was already there on the planet. And he built the fortress on top of it in the vain hopes that he would be able to communicate with Padme through the Force, using like dark side meditation. Which is really heartbreaking when you think about it, because of course, eventually he did not. And the whole thing just ended up being part of Palpatine's larger scheme to just keep him tortured, so. LE4PP, hello there! Thank you for joining me. We're about to dive in here. So without further ado, let us enter the shadow of Vader's castle.
Star Wars Adventures, Shadow of Vader's Castle. By Derek Charm, Nicoletta Baldari, Nick Brokenshire, Francesco Francavilla.
Kevon Scott, Elizabeth Bray, Riley Farmer, and Valeria Lopez. Stealing a little Twilight Child. I like it. These are nods to the Ghosts of Vader's Castle, which was an excellent series from Star Wars Adventures back last Halloween. Here we go. Mustafar. Many years ago. Oh, he's a Kubaz. That's cool. You don't usually see them without their hoods on. All his life, Kakan had wanted to see a Jedi. He had heard so many stories about them. The guardians of peace and life, protectors of the light. And then came the news, a rumor whispered over the fire plains. A Jedi Knight had been spotted on Mustafar, in the lava mines of all places. My mistake, he is not a Kubaz. He's clearly Mustafarian from this context. He just looks like a Kubaz because he's got that big ol'... Well, you know. The boy raced through the mining complex, hardly believing his luck. How many Mustafarians could say they had laid eyes on a genuine hero of the Republic? And there he was, just as Kakan had always imagined, tall and majestic, billowing robes. Oh, fuck, it's Anakin. He's just taken out the Separatist leaders. But something was wrong. Something dark. Something evil. Kakan knew the truth as soon as he saw the stranger's face. This was no Jedi. Amazing. As soon as you see this panel, you know, Battle of the Heroes just starts playing in my head. It's just such a strong, such a vivid association of like that frame of the movie and that part of the soundtrack. It was the eyes that made him run. So full of anger. So full of hate. Oh, look, with just the glowing eyes in this hooded... Oh, this is awesome. I'm really liking this art style so far. That's when I saw them, heading down into the foundry. A Mustafarian boy hunted by a monster. Oh, wait, shit. We've changed perspective here. That's when I saw them, heading down into the foundry. A Mustafarian boy hunted by a monster. Of course, this was before we learned what the monster had done. And why he wanted no witnesses.
Eek!
Grab him by the snout.
Quiet, boy. He mustn't hear us.
Lelis?
Does your broodmother know you're here?
No, I'm sorry. I just wanted to see the Jedi.
The apologies can wait. We just need to get you out of here first. I've worked these mines all my life. The first thing you need to learn is how dangerous it is to play with the repulsor vents.
So what are you doing?
Playing with the vents, of course.
This is cool. Okay, so he's just a small child, and this must be like an adult, fully developed Mustafarian. He's much bigger. This guy's kind of a runt, this little child. Oh, well, that's cool. I love the light streaking on Anakin's right eye here, showing that he's turned his head really quickly. with those glowing eyes in the dark. Yeah, I'm really digging this artwork.
From all of the fumes that drift up from the lava lakes deep underground, these were the most potent. They played tricks with your head. Skywalker. Making you see things that weren't there. Shadows of the mind. Fear. Doubts. What have you done, Skywalker?
Whoa, that's awesome. He may be full of anger and hate, but he still is definitely full of fear, too. Look at that face.
Ghosts of the past, what have you become?
Oh, that's the ghost of Qui-Gon? Oh, man. That's heavy. Yeah, man. Anakin, Qui-Gon would be so disapproving if he could see his actions on Mustafar. And I think that, you know, even after he had fallen to the dark side, Anakin still had Qui-Gon in this high place of reverence. He's the one who freed him. He's the one who gave him his path to being a Jedi. I don't think that, even after becoming Darth Vader, I still don't think he would have wanted to disappoint Qui-Gon. So that's probably a pretty heavy blow to his psyche right now. No! You're not real! Oh shit. Padme, Grievous, all of them. None of you!
That's it, Kick and Climb! We all have things that scare us. There you are!
Ah, he's found me!
We all have things we fear.
Ah! Kagan!
Nothing can hurt me. Not anymore. I am strong. Strong with the dark side you may be.
Whoa.
But weak you are. Always weak. Not worthy to be Jedi. Destroy you we must. Destroy you we will.
Dark side Yoda is terrifying. Look at that face. Yep, that's another person that, well, Darth Vader's probably less concerned with disappointing Yoda, because Yoda was kind of, you know, Yoda's involved with the whole making him spy on the Chancellor and part of his distrust, so he doesn't really care about that relationship, but the Qui-Gon one, I think, really hit him where it hurts.
Lelis, don't let me fall!
I'm trying! Can't hold on!
Ah!
Weak! 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 Weak!
No! 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 No!
We've got Ahsoka, Qui-Gon, Plo Koon over here, Windu, look at all of the Jedi, all of his role models, everyone who looked up to him.
No!
He's really going through some heavy psychological torture right now. Trevor Timmis, Harvey, Welsh MJ, hello there. How you guys doing? To this day, I don't know what saved us. We were thrown out of the mines by an invisible hand. As for the monster with the burning eyes, we never saw him again. Not in that form. But we lived in his shadow for the rest of our lives. Some say he's still out there in the mist. Others say he's gone. As for me, I pray that I never cross that path again. Awesome. And I don't know if you can hear, but the Imperial March just kicked in right when we got to this moment where we're never going to see him in that human form again, because now he is Vader. That's so cool.
Mustafar, many years later, after the Battle of Endor.
Oh! Post-6 Mustafar. I don't believe we've seen it except for that glimpse in Episode 9.
Look, Gigak. Even the storm clouds celebrate. The Empire is no more. We're free.
What are you talking about, Tuttle? None of us are free. Not while we live under the shadow of that fortress. You know the stories as well as I do. Mustafar has been a living nightmare ever since Darth Vader first came here. But you heard the news from the Alliance. The Dark Lord is gone. We have nothing to fear. Nothing to fear? Have you been hailing lava fumes? Did you not hear the howls last night? The cries that echo across the fire plains? Who knows what horrors lurk in that place, just waiting to hunt us down.
I'm regretting the alien voice that I've chosen to do, but you know what? I'm sticking with it. Fuck it! Do it live!
No Mustafarian will be able to rest, unless... Gigak, I recognize that face. I know that face. That's the face that gets us in trouble. No, it's the face that has a brilliant idea. A brilliant idea that will rid us of this Vader's curse now and forever.
Later.
Gigak, what are we doing here? Your uncle still has this equipment from the obsidian mines, yeah? I guess so. That equipment includes detonators. You can't be serious. Oh, I am. That's how we're gonna rid ourselves of Vader's castle once and for all. We're gonna blow it to bits!
You will do no such thing!
Who is it?
Uncle Lillis, we...
I heard what you're planning to do, and I forbid it. Ah, shit, well, they're the same species as this guy, and I've given them goofy voices, and he's got a normal one. It's chaos! Doesn't matter, I'm still doing it.
That place is evil. No one who ventures inside ever comes out alive.
That's not true. I heard about a bunch of rebels who escaped the castle. A woman, a man, and a droid.
Hey! Ghost of Vader's Castle. That was a fun series. I'm loving the reference there.
And if they can do it, so can we. And there's nothing you can do to stop us.
Is that so?
Awesome. He's got a big old bug pet.
Uncle, please! We need to do something!
Why? Because Gigax says so? Why do you always let him lead you astray? Because you want to be heroes? Because you want to go down in legend? Well, if my Zandank won't dissuade you, then maybe a story will. A story of a fool who thought he knew best.
Uh-oh. It's cautionary tale time.
A fool who is never the same again.
This is exactly why I've been sent from Imperial Command.
Look at him, gibbering like a lunatic.
How many troopers is that now?
Please, don't send me back in there. They came up through the floors. Through the floors!
At least a dozen. They've all ended up the same way. Their minds snapped. Or they're just weak, jumping at shadows.
Shadows!
You want to see shadows? Then be my guest, Inspector.
You want to see shadows? Then be my guest, Inspector. Step inside his lair!
Unhand me this instant!
They're everywhere. The eyes. Watching. Waiting. I can't get them out of my head! Out of my head!
Thank you, C7. Have the brute restrained immediately. I'm going to get the bottom of this. Mark my words.
I'm liking that C7 here is like an AP5 style droid, but he looks a little bit more limber and he has a weapon slung on his back, so it's like... AP5's badass cousin, I guess. Elsa Guerrera, I completely agree with you. This comic is so much fun so far. I don't know if I could do every character in that voice. I think I might just, like, die. my vocal cords would leave my body and, like, just run down the road. They'd be like, we're done.
And so the inspector ventured inside the castle.
Hello? Where is everyone?
He wandered from room to room, hallway to hallway, every step leading him deeper into the stronghold's labyrinthine embrace.
Labyrinthine, that's an awesome word, and I never hear that.
Lord Vader? It was only then that he began to wonder if he should have listened to the poor, crazed trooper, when he thought he saw ghostly figures in the shadows, flickering in and out of existence, watching, waiting, herding him on.
Don't be ridiculous, the inspector told himself, continuing his long and winding search. They're just hallucinations, that's all. Illusions, caused by fumes seeping up from underneath the foundations. Yes, that had to be it. This was an Imperial fortress, after all, and he was a loyal subject of the Emperor himself. What did he possibly have to fear?
Lord Vader?
Wow. This is amazing right here.
In the back to tank!
Fun fact, this is like literally what I looked like about 2 weeks ago when I was super sick with a head cold. I felt like I was floating in the back to tank. I was on the couch, didn't do shit all week. It was kind of nice, actually.
What do you want of me?
I have been sent by Moff Suid, the stormtroopers, assigned to the fortress.
They've been going mad.
Oh, shit. I just realized what he's doing. He's using that like, super powerful gas that sent him on his crazy psychedelic journey of self-torture earlier in the issue, and now he's just flooding his meditation chamber with it. He's forcing himself to confront those failures and those emotions. He is deliberately looking into the disappointed eyes of Qui-Gon every single time he goes into this chamber just to torture himself. God, what a powerful level of self-loathing. This comic is really impressing me. Star Wars Adventures has always been geared towards a younger audience, and it's been reflected in the storytelling. It's always been like a little bit less nuanced in that way, but this is getting actually dark, and I respect it. I appreciate it. This is great.
They've been going mad.
I thought they were being weak-minded. But after coming here, these gases, they're incredibly toxic. The castle isn't safe. I can only recommend that we evacuate immediately and install environmental filters.
No.
What do you mean, no? It's all right for you, floating in your tank, wearing a respirator. You don't have to breathe this stuff.
All right for you.
Ah!
Whoa, who is this? He's got, like, the horns of a caliche and, like, the visor of, like, Revan? What the hell's going on here?
Ah!
Crack myself up.
The gases can be filtered. But first, I need a servant. Someone who attend my need.
Is this Vani? Is this how he captures Vani?
No way!
Needs.
Got to get out of here! The trooper was right! The eyes! So many eyes!
And you are the best candidate to arrive for months.
Wait! What? I can't move! Why can't I move?
Because I do not allow it.
Please, the fumes! I can't see! See the most terrible things! Let me go!
Look upon them! Tell me what you see.
No! They're not real! I know they're not real! You can't scare me! I'm an Imperial officer! I laugh at such notions! Ha 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 ha!
And so he laughed. For days. Oh my god, he's turning into the Joker.
And days. Now will you serve me?
Yes. Yes, I will serve you. The voices, they told me.
And what is your name, servants?
My name. My name is Vani. Master.
That's amazing. So this is how... So Vani was just a run-of-the-mill Imperial. I have wanted this for so long. I've wanted this ever since Rogue One. When he shows up in the meditation chamber, he's like, "My lord, Director Krennic has arrived." I thought that he was like maybe one of like Palpatine's like little Sith posse that like Moff... That like Pestage and everyone else belongs to. And he just sort of like... had given one to Vader as an attaché to the castle, and that I kind of had it in my head that he was, like, secretly keeping an eye on Vader and reporting back to Palpatine. But no, he was just some uppity Imperial officer who got gassed in the face, basically got the Scarecrow treatment from Batman, and now he's, like, this mind-fucked manservant. That's awesome. That's much cooler than my headcanon, so this has been really fun. I really like this story so far.
Now will you reconsider?
Because you told us a ghost story, or because you're threatening us with a slobbering beast?
Both. Like, come on, dude. How much persuading do these fucking kids need?
No. Then no, because neither will work on us, you old fool.
Foom.
What the fuck is he doing?
Calm yourself, Cracker. It's only a light. The glare will soon pass. They've gone, haven't they? And they've taken the charges, too. You young fools. Well, we tried to warn them. Now they've only got themselves to blame.
I don't know, Gage. Maybe this isn't such a good idea after all.
Of course it is. Don't tell me you believed all that nonsense about ghosts and spirits.
It was quite convincing, Alfie, all things considered. And what about the fumes? Do you think they can really make you see things that aren't there? Maybe, but they were blocked off years ago.
We'll be fine, I promise you.
But what if you're wrong?
Then we're about to get a shock. Boo! Ah! You're such a scaredy cat. You're such a scaredy sock.
It's not funny, Gabe.
Would it help you if we were armed?
It would help if we went home.
You really are a coward, aren't you?
It's not that. I just can't help thinking of all the stories I heard since I was a grub. Stories like the Sorcerer's Jewel.
The what? You must have heard it. It happened long ago.
It happened long, long ago.
Another story time.
To a girl younger than us.
Let me go! You're hurting me!
Then you should have thought of that before you stole those rations.
I was hungry! My family was hungry. It's soup for my family, officer.
A terrible shame.
A terrible shame. Perhaps we can do something about that.
Who are you?
The man.
The man was a powerful sorcerer.
God damn it. I have to narrate this shit now.
The man was a powerful sorcerer who told her that her family need never again go hungry. If she did what he said.
This kindly old man looks somewhat familiar, doesn't he? He kind of looks like a senate that we know. I wonder if that'll be important later.
If she did what he said.
So, do we have a deal?
The task was simple. The colony was built on the remnants of an old temple, buried deep beneath the ground.
Which we know as a Sith temple, purposefully the reason Vader built his castle on this site.
I know, Welk. Crawling down a spooky shaft is the last thing I want to do, but you saw that creepy old guy. Who knows what he would do if Mom and Dad... Who knows what he would do to Mom and Dad if I said no?
Beep, beep, beep.
I like how she has a Kowakian monkey lizard as a pet, and that's fun. It's about time these things are humanized. They're always, like, full of mischief or, like, an obstacle to the end, to this, in the story. Fish Bosk, how you doing, man? Thanks for joining us. And the Twitch Emmy goes to...
Thank you. I'd like to thank all the little people that didn't tell me about the terrible acting choices I was making when picking voices that would later become the narrator of the entire fucking comic.
Yeah, his troopers could hardly squeeze down here in all that armor, could they? Besides, remember what he said. You are searching for this, my child.
You are searching for this, my child. The gem of the luminous, which, according to legend, can only be found by someone pure of heart.
Which is the real reason he's not going in himself.
Ugh. I heard that. I am pure of heart. Okay, so I help myself to the odd loaf of bloom bread when the baker's not looking. But only the ones that are stale. I'm doing him a favor. Whoa. Look at all this stuff, Welk. Gold? Jewels?
A BD series robot I'm seeing. A speeder bike is parked down here. And you can't see it because it's behind my body, but there's a little Mandalorian helmet. Looks like it's a Old Republic style, like a legacy helmet too, on the ground. Oh, but there's also creepy red eyes in this background area. Look at this. Okay. I'm getting some Smaug's Lair vibes here.
Not to mention tech. Check out that rocket pack. Just think of the getaways we could make with that. Eep, eep, eep. Okay, I get the message. There's no need to push. Gem of the Luminous. Gem of the Luminous. Gem of the... Beware! Beware! Luminous? That doesn't sound good. You are doomed! Doomed! It doesn't look good either.
Ooh. Finally, we're getting some undead zombies up in Star Wars.
But that does. Look, well, that has to be the gem.
Where is she? I don't see the gem.
Turn back! Turn back! No way! I'm almost there! Ah! It's got me! Let go! Let... Psh, psh. Ah! Look out below! Ow, that hurt! Not even being rich beyond the dreams of Buah Mudat is worth this.
Who is Buah Mudat? There's a story there.
Ah! Hang on. They're not even real skeletons. Just droids made up to look as freaky as possible to scare off thieves.
Alright, well there goes my excitement about having undead in Star Wars.
And before you say anything, Welk, yeah, I know we're thieves.
Welk? Welk, where are you? If anything's happened to you, I'll have a complete and utter heart attack, you glorious little kleptomaniac! Ta-da! You found the Luminous. You found it. Now, we gotta get out of here. We gotta get out before we're torn limb from limb. Looks like we're gonna be needing this after all. Alright, rocket pack time. They're not showing us the full pack, and I want to see what kind it is. Hold on to that gem, Welk. Going up. Okay, so she blasted it, but we didn't see it.
And so the Jeep returned the jewel to her sinister employer.
At last! The lore of the ancients will be mine!
Wow, clever trick. Who needs a rocket pack when you can do that?
Ah, curse them! The light! It burns! If I access this gem's records, I may never be able to use my powers again. So be it. If I can't uncover this ancient secrets, no one shall.
So he just destroys it. That's on brand. I see Palpatine doing that.
We leave for Coruscant immediately. There are more artifacts to be found.
And so the girl was left for dead. But just as in the cavern, not everything was as it seems.
Yeah, Welk. I'm awake. And rich! Look at all these jewels!
Now the girl could buy all the bloom bread and rocket packs she wanted.
Doomed!
If she survived the night. Doomed! Seriously? You expect me to believe that pile of bantha poop? And you thought your uncle's stories were nonsense. It even proves my point. The zombies were just droids, no more real than the phantoms that are supposed to haunt this place. For the last time, Turtle, there's no such thing as ghosts. Now set the charges and we can blow this monstrosity sky high. Now set the charges and we can blow this monstrosity sky high.
Hello?
What was that? I told you, it's the lava fumes playing tricks on our minds.
Is anyone up there?
But you also said the fumes were blocked. That voice. It's real. And it's coming from down there.
Please help me. I'm trapped.
What are you doing? You heard them. Whoever they are, they can't get out.
Pshhh. Hello? Oh man, you stupid kids.
Oh, thank Lockfit. I've been down in this pit for so long with only the spark roaches for company. Lovely, crunching spark roaches.
Gross. That's it. We're leaving them down, though.
We can't. Especially if we're going to bring this place down around his ears. Who put you down there?
The Dark Lord. He was angry. But I did nothing wrong. Nothing wrong at all.
We've got to get him out. Grab some of these tapestries. We can tie them together to make a rope.
We must be mad.
No. You were kind. Both of you. Not like the Dark Lord. He was cruel.
Yeah, but he's gone now.
Gone? That's impossible. He was so powerful. I thought nothing could defeat him. Although many tried.
Lord Vader, you came.
Yes, I knew you would. Knew you would.
I trust you have made progress. I trust you have made progress, Dr. Reston.
Oh yes, the most wonderful progress. Just me and my droids. I couldn't trust anyone with my research, you see. Not another living soul.
Not even your assistant?
That treacherous fool? He tried to betray me, my lord. Tried to destroy my work!
And where is he now, this traitor of yours?
Oh, he's still here and very much part of the experiment.
Lord Vader. The Emperor. You have to stop him. He's mad. Quite mad.
What does he mean?
Cranwell doesn't understand, but it's fine. Absolutely fine. He doesn't need to.
What is that? What did you just inject into me?
The culmination of my life's work. A genetic serum activated by a specific sound wave. In this case, the savage squeal of a Gamorrean.
A what? No!
Here. Let me demonstrate.
Beep.
That's my Gamorrean. I know it's terrible.
Vader, listen to me. You have to listen. He...
Oh, shit.
He...
Oh my god, he fucking turned into a Gamorrean? That's amazing. He did say it was a genetic serum. I love it. I love the Hulk reference here with his shorts. That's... And the purple for the... Oh, I see you guys. I see you guys.
Fascinating.
Fascinating? Is that all you can say?
This experiment has merit. Infect a rebel agent with your serum and send them back to the Alliance.
Then broadcast the squeal on a subspace frequency and unleash the monster. Yes! Yes, that would be good. But not as good as destroying you!
It's free! Protect Lord Vader!
Oh shit, Vader versus Hulk Gamorrean? I dig it.
You don't understand. My creations are unstoppable! And that's not all. The merest touch of their sweaty hides transmits the infection immediately. None of you stand a chance!
Look at this. Look at the visual of these guys in their little plasteel fighter just getting huge, turning into Gamorreans. Really going Hulk is the only way I can describe it. That's amazing. Man, this comic just keeps giving and giving.
Incorrect. I do not need to touch my enemies to defeat them.
That's right.
Including you.
Put me down! Put me down!
Not until you confess.
Confess what? How you ruined my life? Destroyed everything I ever loved? When you blew up Alderaan, my family, my friends, that Viper Tarkin may be gone, but you remain. I vowed I would bring you down. I didn't care how it happened. Being ripped limb from limb, transformed into a hideous monster.
As long as you had your vengeance. Just as your assistant warned when he contacted my Star Destroyer.
You knew? And you came anyway. Why?
So I could see for myself.
My genius?
No. Your destruction.
Whoosh. Ah! Nice. Gamorrean projectiles hurled via the Force. That's not a pretty way to go.
Get off me, you blundering brutes! You mustn't touch me! No! No, no!
This is amazing. The overdone liquidity of it all, the saliva and the nostrils and the eye goop and stuff, really reminds me of some of the early illustrations in the Heavy Metal magazine, especially the ones by Enki Bilal back in the day. Really has that vintage feel to it. Really digging it.
Darth Vader wasn't afraid of becoming a monster after all. That happened a long time ago.
I believe you. Now hurry up and give me your hand, idiot.
Thank you. My hero.
Careful, you'll pull me.
Ah! Oh dear. How clumsy of me.
Why did you do that? We tried to save you.
Yes. But you also threatened to blow up my master's fortress, and I cannot allow that.
Your master? Who are you?
It's Vane, isn't it?
Who am I? I am the servant of the Dark Lord, the one true acolyte of the Beyond. I am Vane, keeper of the Obsidian Flame. I am death to all who profane the name of the Sith.
Awesome. He's also just a crazy old man in a robe holding a stick, but, you know, that's neither here nor there at this point.
Look at that face.
You are finished!
What? You survive?
Yeah, I survived, and I still have the detonator. Total, if you can hear me, run! Run as fast as you can! And tell everyone what we did.
Click! And you're a brave kid.
I did what Giga asked, and I ran as fast as I could. The detonators hadn't been long enough. Hadn't been enough. The castle still stood. But Giga's sacrifice had not been in vain. We hadn't leveled the Dark Lord's castle, but we had buried his thrall. Hadn't we?
Foolish child! Haven't you heard?
The Sith are hard to kill. But what if they were speaking the truth? What if my master is truly gone?
Do not fear, faithful servant.
What? Who is there?
You know my voice, Vane. Did I not speak to you in the pit, in the darkness, in the smoke? Did I not speak to you in the lava itself?
Yes. Yes. I hear you, old lord. Speak words of hope to me and I will obey.
It is not over. Not yet. Not while you can bring him back. Your master will return to the fires of Mustafar, and this time, he will be made whole. Vader triumphant. Vader supreme. Vader reborn! To be continued in Ghosts of Vader's Castle.
Whoo, man! I'm not gonna lie, I have never had a very high bar for Star Wars adventures just because it always seems to be so oriented for a younger audience. I feel like I'm just sort of not inside that demographic. But this impressed me in so many different ways. The artwork was top-notch. It really felt evocative to a lot of the things that have come before it in decades past while still bringing something new to the table. The storytelling was great. They managed to fit 3 mini-stories into a single issue. It's like an anthology in and of itself. And just anytime we get a taste of more of Vader's fortress, I just feel like it's a treat, because that's such a lore-heavy, like, mysterious location within Star Wars. And I love getting more of it. Jumping into the chat here for a second. How's it going, everybody? I hope you enjoyed that. We still have one more to go. We're moving on to Star Wars number 8 by Charles Soule and Ramon Rosales. Let's get her done. The Will of Tarkin. Pray. So I'm very excited for this as well. Just because the last issue was so killer. And Zara has really been developed into a pretty sweet bad guy, and I'm worried that they're going to follow the usual trend of introducing a badass Imperial foil for either Leia or for Han, having them last like maybe one arc, and then they're gone. I would love it if we could have at least one straight-up member of the Imperial rank and file who is a villain who could stick around at least all the way up until episode 6, like, establish them now in this time period between 4 and 5, like they did with Zara. Explain a way for them to survive episode 6, and then kill them in The Mandalorian, make them live action. Boom, there you go. But that's just my 2 cents. Alright, let's do it. Star Wars number 8, Charles Soule and Ramon Rosales.
The Will of Tarkin, Part 2, Pray. The heroic Rebel Alliance is scattered and on the run from the evil Galactic Empire after losing the Battle of Hoth. Princess Leia attempts to rally her friends before all hope is lost. But the Empire's cunning commander Zara has broken Rebel security codes and will stop at nothing to crush the Rebels once and for all. Zara now strings her deadliest trap yet on the unsuspecting Rebel fleet.
Uh-oh.
Coruscant! After Cloud City!
We believe the remnants of the Rebel fleet scattered into small cells after Hoth, to rendezvous at some predetermined time.
They will be hunted down and destroyed. Every last ship, every last Rebel, burned to ash. It must happen now, while they are at their weakest, disorganized and afraid.
Is that your command, my master?
Thrawn or Tarkin would be perfect for the assignment, but both are gone, and few in my empire rise to that level of skill. I do not like delaying your search for the son of Skywalker, Lord Vader, but perhaps you must be the one to hunt down the remaining rebels.
No. There is another.
And we're back in Kessel. I did not expect to come here anytime soon. Commander Zara, we have an incoming transmission for you. Yeah? And who might be calling for the likes of me, Lieutenant?
Let me guess. Emperor Palpatine himself, and he's gonna give me a medal?
Man, so Zara really had an upward rise after the destruction of the Death Star. She's got this bullshit assignment here, commanding a mining facility on Kessel. She doesn't even have her jacket on. She got her feet up. Like, Clearly she had a dead-end post before all of this happened. No, Commander, but nearly. It's Lord Vader.
What? What did you say? Don't just stand there and prepare my uniform!
You are alien Zara. You worked closely with Governor Tarkin before he perished on the Death Star. He spoke of you on occasion. It is my understanding he gave you personal instruction in his methods, his strategies, tactics.
Yes, Lord Vader. He was a great teacher, a mentor to me.
Then why did he place a note in your file indicating you were to be given non-essential duties until further notice?
I failed him, Lord Vader. He gave me an assignment and did not complete to his satisfaction. It is my belief that he intended this period in my career to serve as an object lesson, and had he lived, I would have received an opportunity to redeem myself in his eyes.
Yes, that sounds like talking. He once taught me something as well, on a world called Shandar's Folly. I found his lessons instructive.
Nice! I love the reference to Tarkin by James Luceno. Great book if you haven't read it.
You will have the opportunity for redemption denied to you by the rebels. I am placing you in charge of the effort to hunt down the remnants of the rebel fleet. You will be given all necessary resources.
Lord Vader, I am honored. I will not fail you.
See that you do not. This assignment does not come solely from me. The Emperor knows your name. This is either your greatest opportunity or the worst moment of your life. Time will tell.
There's Vader knocking it out of the park with those excellent pep talks again. Now.
Now! The Tarkins will!
Commander Zara, forgive the question, but if I did not ask, I'd be neglecting my duty.
Look at this battle raging out here. As this Imperial Star Destroyer is broadsiding this MC-85. Got a Nebulon frigate, interceptors. Oh, this is gorgeous. I love space battles depicted in comics. There's always just so much to draw your eye, and you can just linger on a page forever and just keep drinking in the details.
Under ordinary circumstances, perhaps not.
Sorry, I have to go back.
Commander Zara, forgive the question, but if I did not ask, I would be neglecting my duty. You are the commanding officer of this assault group. Is it a wise course of action to lead a boarding party into the midst of an ongoing battle?
Under ordinary circumstances, perhaps not. But an incredibly valuable target is on board one of their ships. It is worth the risk.
But we are facing two rebel divisions. The 7th and the 4th. Surely someone else could...
No, Lieutenant Gore. It must be me. I trust no one else to complete this mission.
Besides, you've been shadowing me ever since we began hunting the rebels. Until I return, just do what I would do.
That's good advice.
All right. The Sentinel shuttle is approaching the Nebulon B.
Hurry! They're already in the airlock!
And they're here. Boom!
Ah!
Let's cut a path!
I'm sorry. Her outfit is awesome. The helmet, goggles, chin strap combo. She just looks real dorky. She looks like the super Nazis from the first Captain America movie. You know what I'm talking about? When they're all juiced up with the Hydra fluid and they're like, that's what she looks like. Let's cut a path. But also, she's flanked by a whole bunch of A New Hope style space troopers, which is a badass look. And two of them even look like they have the rebreathers from the Battlefront magma troopers that you see on Sullust.
Luke, how is it out there? Are you holding on?
We're hanging in, Leia. The Imperials have the 7th Division's cruiser pinned down, so they haven't been able to scramble their fighters yet. We're helping where we can. Right, R2?
Boom!
Leia, we've been boarded.
Wait, did you say they've been boarded? Leia, are you?
Luke, I gotta go. Just keep flying.
But...
Rebel scum!
Ah! Ho ho ho! Blaster in one hand, vibroblade in the other. These guys are just dropping... Oh man, their little DC-17s are no match.
A boarding party? Commander Greck, are we in danger?
No, it's a small squad, and I've sent teams down to handle it. Shouldn't be a problem.
Come on, engine room's this way.
I love seeing this shootout taking place with these very, very familiar hallways. It really reminds me of the close quarters map from the Battlefront 2 in 2005. The Tantive was my favorite map to play indoors on.
I just don't see the point of sending a boarding party at all. Sabotage doesn't make sense. If they wanted to blow us up, they've got a Star Destroyer. They wouldn't have sent a team for no reason. There has to be something they want aboard this ship. It's you, Leia. They want you. Oh, now what?
Commander Greck, we've got a problem. Flare up in the primary reactor. One of the safety systems must have failed. It's building to critical.
Send a crew down to the engine room. We have to get that locked down right away.
My name is Commander Zara of the Imperial Navy. I have deactivated the safety controls on your main reactor. This ship will explode in a matter of minutes. That, however, is not my reason for boarding this vessel. I am here for Princess Leia Organa.
Epic. She's... Man, I like Zara a lot. She really is holding a candle to Natazi Dalla of Legends right now in a much more hands-on way. I saw a comment a second ago saying that it's from Trevor Timmons. I love that Tarkin's presence is still felt. It absolutely is. And you really feel like Zara really is a furtherance, a continuation of Tarkin's presence in this universe, you know, in the best possible way.
Send her to the engine room.
Send her to the engine room alone. She can bring any weapons she likes. It won't matter. The moment I see her again alone, I will reactivate the limiters on your reactor.
And what do you want with her?
Well, just a conversation. That's all.
You can't do this, Leia. It's obviously a trap.
Lend me your blaster, Greck. If it's my life against everyone's on the ship, my choice is simple. I don't think I have one.
All right, let's do this.
Meanwhile, in space.
We've got to clear those fighters, R2. Home 1 can't launch any ships with that many TIEs blockading its hangar bay.
That is a shit ton of interceptors. Look at them all go.
This is Red Leader. All fighters on me. We need to make an attack run on 7th Division's cruiser. Push those TIEs back.
This is Green 3. The A-Wings are forming up alongside you, Luke. We're ready.
Thanks, Shara.
Hey, it's Shara Bay. It's Poe Dameron's mama.
That's awesome.
Thanks, Shara. Chewie, Lando, what about you? You with me?
Another day, another attack run. Guess I'll head over to the guns. We really gotta get away from these people, Chewbacca.
Stay on me. Don't let up.
Roger that, Red Leader.
That's it. They're breaking formation.
Oh, yes. Targeting computer. You love to see it.
Red 2 here. Thanks for the assist, you guys. We'll be out with you. We'll be out there with you right away.
Wait. Is that... Wedge!
Yes!
In the flesh, Luke. Now that you've cleared the way...
Oh my god.
Let's see if we can repay the favor. Look at this. Look at all these ships. My god, it's beautiful. And Wedge!
Wedge is back. They got in the same helmet.
Okay, let's see what I can recognize here, because I'm sure that these are all canon. We got Red Squadron. That's also Red Squadron. Down here, this Y-Wing in the back is Anvil Squadron livery. Green Squadron and Yellow Squadron had different names, but I'm blanking on them. That is the same livery as the Blue Squadron that got wiped out over the Battle of Scarif. This is amazing. What a moment.
Princess Organa. Pleasure to meet you.
That's cool. Usually you see this from the other side of the door. I like that perspective change up. Check in with my chat here before I continue to the big moment. Yes, the blue and green A-Wing. Let me go back. Yes, the A-Wings here look really good. All of the ships. That's the one thing. The Star Wars art has really had some ups and downs with the new Marvel canon series. I think it hit a low point with Salvador LaRocca doing the faces, but even then, the ships were gorgeous. The ships have always been gorgeous.
Princess Organa, a pleasure to meet you.
Oh, warning shot straight away. I took out the control panel for the door you just came through. You won't be getting out that way. But there's another exit on the other side of the engine room. Make it there and you'll make it there alive and you can go. I've reset the reactor as promised and my blaster is in its holster. It'll stay there. I give you my word. In the meantime, let's talk.
Oh, she actually wants to talk. I did not see that coming.
I know a great deal about you. The Empire has extensive files. You weren't born in Organa. You were adopted. You're an orphan. I'm an orphan too. My entire family was killed in a rebel terrorist attack when I was young. I was alone. For a very long time, I survived. For a very long time. Eventually, I signed up at the Imperial Academy to make sure nothing like what happened to me would ever happen again. I wanted to save other little girls' families. And then came Wilhuff Tarkin. Ah! Did it get the gun? What happened? Oh, shit. No, it got her. He thought I had promise and took me into his orbit. He taught me everything. He gave me guidance, support, education. Everything I am, he made me. And then you stole the plans for the Death Star. This is a great shootout, and they're just like firing into the mist here. You were captured and brought to the battle station. Such a prominent rebel required a high-level interrogation. I believe this is why Governor Tarkin himself went to the Death Star to oversee your questioning. And why he was aboard it when it was destroyed in yet another attack by your terrorist organization. An attack you engineered. He died thinking I was a failure, Princess. I no longer have the chance to show him I am not, thanks to you. But I can avenge his death. That will have to be enough. Prepare yourself. I intend to take my time with this.
And Zara is really grinding that axe right now. Commander Zara.
Commander Zara, the 2nd Rebel Division has rallied. We are taking significant fire. We cannot defeat both. We cannot defeat both. I am preparing the Tarkin's will to jump to lightspeed. I urge you to return immediately.
Hmm?
I think you're on the wrong ship.
Woo! Yes!
Remember me, Princess. Remember my blade. You will see both of us again. And you, Skywalker. I could kill you here and now.
You think so?
Yes, I do!
Whoa. I love it. Luke's not even really, like, surprised by this. He's just sort of, like, bemused and impressed. He's like, whoa, she really threw that knife. Good for her.
Think. Nice. But I've been ordered not to. Lord Vader has plans for you.
Well, she actually got one over on him. She just throws on the gas mask and just blasts her way out the window. That's badass. Take that, Iden Versio. I think you just got one up for the coolest rebel ship evac.
This is Commander Zara. I'll be aboard in 30 seconds. Prepare to jump to light speed. By the Emperor, you made it.
Order acknowledged. That's amazing. Look at that, and she just rockets right back into it. Talk about leading from the front. You gotta give Zara props. She's got massive Imperial balls.
This is a grand day. The fleet is coming back together, and we just showed the Imperials that we aren't out of the fight yet. Not even close. This is just the beginning of the work we need to do. But let's take this moment to breathe. Even to celebrate a little bit. And that, my friends, is an order. You all right, Leia?
You saw her eyes, didn't you, Luke? She wanted to hurt me. All the pain she's felt in her life. She wanted to make me feel it, too. I have enemies, of course, but this felt different. Darker. This was hate.
Organa's been blooded, Gore. This was a good day. But you weren't able to kill her? I thought that was your plan. The whole reason that mission was worth the risk.
Of course I wanted to kill her, Lieutenant. But I have to do it the right way.
There will be another opportunity. And in many ways, this is better.
Nah, fuck you. You killed a Tauntaun and put it on the wall? That's just mean. How much of a challenge is killing a Tauntaun? They seem like they're pretty useless.
Leia knows I won't stop until I have her.
This blade will be the last thing she thinks about before she goes to sleep, and the first thing she sees when she wakes up. I did more damage to the Rebellion in that engine room than 1,000 Star Destroyers could in that moment. In the darkness, I took away her hope. It will affect her choices in every engagement she plans from now on, every inspiring speech she tries to give. She's not a fighter. She's a symbol. She helps the Rebels believe they can defeat any enemy. In order to do it, she has to believe it too. But I took that away. And it's just the beginning.
All right. Well, that was also an awesome issue. I loved the duality of the space battle going on with this engine room showdown. Take out the chat here. Official boss, she's so badass. I need to catch up with these comics. I love the new character. Yes. Zara is absolutely a new badass character. And as I said before we dove into this new one, I was kind of nervous that she was about to die. I'd love it if we could spend some time just lingering on these moments with these badass Imperial people, showing things from their perspective. And then eventually, of course, they get defeated because that's what happens in these stories. But, like, don't rush it. You know, let us take our time. And it sounds like they're going to give us a slow burn with this Zara-Leia rivalry. And I'm here for it. I also like that this is the first time we've got someone who's not just sort of like, we will crush their ships and destroy their planets and blah, 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 rule the galaxy. She's not like that at all. She's like, I'm going to fuck this bitch up, and I'm going to do it psychologically, and I'm going to mindfuck her, and I'm going to break her spirit. She's coming at it like a mean girl rather than like a military commander. But also there is like the military aspect. So it's just a very interesting dynamic, and I'm really looking forward to seeing where that goes next. So I thought that Star Wars Adventures number 2 by Michael Moreci and Megan Levins was also coming out today. That was one of the comics that was originally slated to come out back in June, and then it was pushed to November because of COVID, like a lot of other titles were. I thought it was pushed to November 4th. It's actually pushed to November 25th, so I'll be getting into that one in a later stream, not doing it today. So these are the two that we've got so far. What issue does she come in? Zara came in at the beginning of the new 2020 Star Wars run. So she comes in Star Wars number 1 of 2020, taking place between 5 and 6. Yeah, so. Cool. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you all on the Discord, on the channel. We've got Mandalorian reaction coming this week. Make sure to go onto Patreon and respond to the poll if you haven't already. Looking forward to that coming soon. And everyone else, thanks again for watching. And as always, may the Force be with you.